comes in, and they ban out heroes like Beastmaster and Bounty, who can give that vision maybe further and deeper into their side of the map.
Same bans, same first pick, different team though.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's mixed around a little bit this time. Ryan was first pick last time for Team Secret, so it switched over. I think the Enchantress was the same ban as last time.
I think both teams just recognizing what's going to be the highly contested supports and kind of cores in this series. So they ban out some of the cores, the Lion, something that perhaps Newbie would have wanted if they could have got their hands on the last game, and they're going to make sure they do with their first pick.
Early Dazzle.
Now that comes out of nowhere, kind of.
That is not a hero that would have gotten banned out in the second phase, either.
But Puppy being a bit of a mystery, a Houdini at times, and that's that first pick Dazzle, definitely something that's going to throw Newbie off a bit.
Mm-hmm. 10 seconds remaining. So normally we see offliners picked aka Darkseer in this case. I thought Universe played a good Darkseer. There's I was going to say that it should
Puppy
be.
Puppy agrees with you.
Yeah, yeah.
He's like, okay, we can do that again.
Darkseer's over there right now going, Shiva says Darkseer, I think we should pick Darkseer.
Is this good. Last game, their pair up was obviously they could have a vacuum into an Earthspike, and we saw amazing Earthspikes coming out from Pylodai. What are they going to try to pair up with the Darkseer this game?
I think with Secret, with their cores, they want to have some more pushing power. The Lifestealer plus Quap to me wasn't the ideal for duo. That's something I mentioned during the draft, and even later to Gareth again, is I think the SF would have been a better mid pick for them.
Okay.
Perhaps they just haven't felt like SF has come back in the meta, but we've seen Liquid run the SF successfully.
As of late.
No, they're not.
Blitz isn't here. No, you'd have to whisper.
Jakiro mid?
No, they're not.
We said that last time, and it ended up being Jakiro.
Sound like a broken record here. I really like the IO though, so that's Kaka's support. But I think yesterday, guys, we were talking that you didn't like C2 supports locked down at the same time. Was it you that said that, or someone else?
I don't mind it too much. It does go away. I mean, it kind of, as long as it depends what those two supports do, because you've got burst damage and lock. Like, if you have no disables and you pick your first two supports, then it reveals a lot. If you do IO Dazzle as your opener, I think that's kind of a weak opener, but it fits Newbie's cores that they like to run. These tanky pushing cores with the IO really effective. The Lion just guarantees they have some lockdown and a playmaking hero for Chuan, which is always what he wants to be on. Last game was the Disruptor, this game the Lion.
What weaknesses does the openings leave for the teams, for the other team to exploit?
I think there's less that you leave weaknesses. For Secret, it means you can't really run a jungle. Well, you know you're not going to run a jungle now that the two supports have been picked up with the Darkseer. For the IO Lion, it means that Secret can build kind of strong team fight to help fight around the way Newbie play with IO and just the relocate in general. Maybe we see like a Puppy Enigma come out. Possibility. That's something that was more like an EG style pick where you see your opponents pick IO, you go into like Enigma and Tidehunter and heavy team fight or Enigma Darkseer. Pylodai is not normally the Dazzle player though, it's normally the Puppy hero, but if they feel Enigma's going to fit the bill, they might pick it anyways. So Viper and Batband out, something we saw Newbie run the Viper when they had this kind of heavy sustained lineup. There's still like Bristleback in the pool, Dragon Knight, Juggernaut. There's plenty of heroes that can go well with this. And those are the kind of heroes I expect Newbie to pick up. Bristle, tank, frontline cores that can benefit a lot from having the IO behind them.
Yeah, back to your point about like weaknesses of opening up double supports, it means that you can focus your bans a lot more against other players because you know that Kako is obviously not going to be playing Phoenix this game, so you can look towards your KP and your Mu heroes especially. But not the same for Newbie. It's a difficult ban out here. You know, you could look for Arteezy's Invoker or something like that, maybe, because he's practiced that a hell of a lot.
Yeah. Envy, same as last game. The Ember Spirit's still in the pool, though. That was banned out in game one. And I've so many times with Secret, I feel like they just fall back on Jackie's Ember Spirit when they're in a bit of a bind.
Especially if you get like the Lawnmower Ember Spirit going with Iron Shell Flame Guard. You can run at people a fair amount. 5 seconds remaining.
Clark and Spectre removed on the side of Newbie. They're still banning out some of the Envy cores that they're maybe a little bit worried about. Last game, I believe they banned out Ember against him.
Yeah, it would.
Would you think that Ember is still like why not ban Ember rather than the Slark Spectre?
I think they Direside Embers, like, again, you want to have some Roche taking potential, which Slark and Spectre themselves don't particularly have, so in some ways they're also not great for taking Roche, but Ember is particularly bad at Roche. And that's where I think most scary, we talk about the Ember being a fallback for Jackie, the other fallback for Team Secret has been Droranger strats. If anything, I wouldn't mind seeing them go for like a third pick, either support or ranged mid, and then fourth pick the Droranger. Because that's been like a, we're in trouble, we need to win a game, let's pick a Droranger.
And then they can actually focus on objective taking.
Yep.
But super important for
ET, so they get the support. Pick. And then newbie know exactly what they want. The DK kind of mentioned, like, they're picking DKs, bristles, jugs.
Why pick the ET so early, though?
It's
shrug your shoulders and say it's Poppy.
He's maybe trying to disrupt the think process.
I think the one kind of common and consistent things Puppy's done with his drafting is saving Envy and Ortiz's heroes for last. Like, not just in game one of this series, but at ESL Manila, they were almost always picking up their carry and their mid in their last two picks. That was very much something which was consistent with his style. And that, it's like a hero that you can pick later in the draft, but it also doesn't reveal too much. Like, newbie are going to pick kind of tanky frontline heroes regardless. DK, very good against all the time because you get the bonus armor, which doesn't get taken away by natural order. 5 seconds
remaining. We could even see one of those dual lane scenarios. We saw it from, was it Complexity or was it earlier today?
A Death Prophet.
Where it had like Iron Shell all the time and just run at people. And with a Wisp that might be looking towards the mid lane, you know, we see Kaka focusing on controlling runes and regening up mid. ET can just run at the line and punch him down.
So big kind of criticism we had of Secret's game one draft was they didn't take objectives well. They fixed that with the Death Prophet. It's still the only hero they have for objective taking, but it's a very good one. So they can guarantee towers if they win a fight, if they've still got Exorcism up. Roshan, similarly, you can force a Roche using Exorcism. And this just gives you a much kind of clearer approach and game plan going into game number two. But a hero that needs to be careful not to get run over too much in the mid-game. Burst damage is there from the Lion. A good front line, the DK, who's got high armor, who doesn't just melt to the Exorcism as well.
Percentage-based damage up against newbie, who like to go for these strength heroes, against the DK in particular. It kind of says, try and pick Bristle, try and pick another one of these strength heroes, and Death Prophet will run over you. Because, you know, in these fights, DK and Bristle, they're not that maneuverable. You know, they've got decent move speed, and they can get in and out of fights a little bit, but they like to stand their ground and just battle head-to-head. If the Death Prophet's got her ulti popped, you can't really do that.
And Gyrocopter again. So they're going to get the strong laning carry against Darkseer, and it worked out for them in game number one. So they'll continue that. And Gyrocopter, not really talked about so much as being a tanky frontline core, but he really is.
The way he builds him.
Yeah, the itemization for this hero, we saw Dragonlance last game. He has really high armor. He gets tons of HP survivability items with BKB plus SMY, butterflies. Like, pretty much all of Gyro's like core items give him survivability. You're not seeing MKB's Gyrocopters anymore. You're not seeing Daedalus's until much later on. The Rapier is that late game desperation item.
They even ban out the Bristle.
The Bristle could have easily been run as an offlaner, I think, with the IO. That was pretty much what newbie did in a game yesterday, I believe, with the IO Bristle. Reserve
time. That's what OG did earlier as well, of course.
Yeah. See what KP's hero is going to be. He's played offlane Jug a few times. I'm not sure if you'll really want to Jug this game, though.
Oh, hey, look. The EE Ember.
Yeah,
still
remove that one. A nice little interaction as well with Dazzle Weave and Exorcism, that minus armor. Akko over onto the DK as well as the supports. Akko could have been good with a Sleight of Fist.
Right, so team fight, survivability in the front lines. This also gives them a clear like mech and pipe builder as well to kind of match up to what the Darkseer is going to bring to the table. Gives them a ton of sustain as well.
So no Ember, no Slark, no Spectre. Drowranger doesn't really fit here too nicely. Eternal Envy. What does it even go for?
It's Tide.
No, not Jakiro. Red Eye, please. Oh!
What?
They watched OG, apparently.
Okay.
So I was wondering if he pulls out the PA or something.
Okay. I mean, the interesting thing is that we've already seen it from OG. Jida Day. Mm-hmm. And Secret have obviously had the same thought around this, the same kind of composition as well. So does it work for them?
I think it worked really well for OG because they had two defensive supports. They also had two tanky cores. They had the Bristleback and the Dragonite to push towers very well. Like, the Husker was playing from behind the whole game. Bristle and DK were taking towers, so I don't think it works as well here for Secret.
All right, let's find out. We will be heading over to our commentary team for game number two. Toby, one, and Blitz, it's all yours.
You know what? I was almost disappointed. One, because of Red's handoff, it wasn't creative at all. But two, I'm not. I got a Husker pick up. Blitz, we saw it earlier today. OG, Gods was remaining, saying, like, they coupled it with a DK as well as a Bristleback. What is Secret thinking by picking up this Husker as their final?
It's one of the best direct counters to the Gyrocopter. The Gyrocopter relies so heavily on cooldown and even more than that, the Rocket Barrage. This has been one of the counter since forever. I think it was, I casted a best of five way back when. It was NIP versus, what was that team? Vega. Back when NIP was still together, and they drafted a Huskar into a Gyrocopter, and they forced the Gyro to play support. Like, that's how bad it was. And then they just last picked Wraith King, who they initially planned on making a support. They actually had to swap things around. That's how bad it was.
And we'll see if they swap the roles in this game, but either way, We can actually see what lanes we're going to get. So at this point, no surprise Universe to be on the off lane. Poppy actually picks up a PMS as well as a set of Tangos to go this off lane to start with. And Newbie, after seeing the fact that the ET as well as the Darkseer on bottom lane, are they... 30 seconds. It looks like a bit more of a rotation here.
Yeah.
They're switching KP, the Tidehunter, to the bot lane. So they can have the Tide up against the ET as well as the Darkseer.
They're just trying to understand what lanes Secret are going to go to, because they want to dodge this Huskar against the Gyrocopter, because obviously the Gyro is not going to be able to do too much in this situation, so trying to make sure that he gets a decent matchup. But
if they're going to dodge that, they got to send the DK to the top lane. That's the only other way to do that. The
battle begins. You're okay with this.
So you're okay with like the EE safe lane Huskar up against the Gyro off lane?
Yeah. This is, I think, the ideal situation for Secret in a lot of ways. You would rather have your tri lane against the solo Darkseer. And now the Darkseer gets a one-on-one matchup against a melee hero. Granted, it is a Tidehunter, and both of these heroes are kind of really well-known for beating melees, but...
Oh, Pylite die. You're gonna say hello to Chorn as well as Karka to start with. It's only a little bit of damage. I think more than that. Even with Eternal Envy coming in to lend some Burning Spears, they're okay with this because Karka, he's already got the bottle coming to the top lane. And they're shipping Puppy straight away to this defensive tri-lane now of Secret.
Using up a lot of that mana. And now Puppy's gonna force these two heroes out with the poor man shield. It is nigh impossible to trade hits with them. And this is just gonna enable an Envy to get the one-on-one matchup against Hao. Hao obviously gonna be really strong here when Envy's still only level one. No Berserker's Blood quite yet.
Still interested to see how long they can keep it up. Like, as you said, like, with Berserker's Blood, Envy's gonna get a lot stronger. But you've still got Karka giving a huge amount of regeneration to Hao early on. Thanks to the early bottle, so how can he be as aggressive as he wants to be at this point? Unfortunately, Chorn can't say the same. Puppy is just an absolute beast, and in fact, Karka now has to tether himself down Chorn. As Hao becomes a space creator, and everyone's just, like, pumping out so much damage, but no one's actually near death yet.
Both of these lanes, relatively defensive. Eternal Envy, gonna be pretty hard for them to kill once he gets at level 2. Same with the Dazzle. Puppy has that poor man shield, so both supports not very effective at trading hits with him. The matchup I'm more curious about is the one here at bottom, as Universe is kind of doing Darkseer things. Trying to make it hard for this Tidehunter to trade hits, but Tidehunter getting kind of lowish on regen. And once Universe gets his soul ring, he's going to be in a much better position anyways.
I think KP will have to do it tough, but it does mean you're going to get an early level 6 over on this Tidehunter. Universe isn't going to be really denying up any of these creeps, so at least, you know, you're going to have that Ravage timing to combo up with the rest of the top lane.
Yeah. Something I want to point out about Newbie 2 is, during their original TI run, it was really founded on these two cores, Hao and Mu, and Hao sometimes still makes some confusing decisions in, like, his Spectre game, I think I saw earlier, but Mu has just been an absolute god. This guy has been playing at a tier 1 level, even when his team was on a downswing. Now he's got two supports that really know how to make things work. And Chuan really finding their rhythm on this team.
Yeah, their movement's just so wonderful. Right now, Puppy and Pylite, they're still being watched like a hawk by this Observer Ward. They can't pull the camp because the Sentry Ward is still blocking up the normal pull point. And the Observer Ward behind, the second you try and rotate anyone else over, Nubi have a very early detection of this, and they committed both of their Ops Wards to this top lane. They really want this top lane to work for them. And so far, it kind of has. Like, Eternal Envy is getting almost no CS. Like, he's 5-for-4 up against the 12-for-2. CS of the Gyrocopter.
Yeah, the good news though is that Darksphere at bottom has absolute free farm. And this is kind of what you expect just because they don't really have the best way to pressure Nubi because they don't have any disables or anything like that. Mid lane move, just constantly getting pelted by this Spirit Siphon.
Just harassing him out, but you still got a DK with 2 points up in Dragon Blood. That level of harassment doesn't really seem to do that much, especially when now Kaka will also arrive.
They really both need runes here.
They couldn't get the top one before because each time Secret, they rotate both their supports to control up the top rune. So both Kaka as well as Mu can't pick it up.
Gonna be real rune at top. It's gonna be for Arteezy as Mu. Gonna be bottleless. And Darkseer even takes that one at bottom, so that might actually just force Kaka to go back. That might prompt Secret to get aggressive here at top, as this mid lane...
Moose taking way too much damage. Yeah, she got locked in by his own creep wave! Oh boy, the double damage rune gives the extra bit of damage he requires, but it's the Crypt Swarm that finishes the job.
Why did I praise him?
Yeah, you shouldn't, it's the cast curse.
Yeah, exactly.
That's instantly how you know it, and that's easy. Doesn't waste any time, he's got a catapult wave. He does not want Kaka dragging the creep wave off, but... like, there was no option there.
He's just trying to deal damage to the tower while he can. And this really hurts the DK because this is Dragon Knight's job. This is usually what you're going to see the Dragon Knight do. Rotate over, push out the lane, and Kaka going to have his own bottle refilled by the Dragon Knight, but still, good lane so far for the DP. They're able to get the solo kill on him. That rarely, if ever, happens in Tier 1 battles now in mid, where you get solo killed.
It's almost like you just got screwed by the creeps that came up behind him. Like, there was just no way for him to walk away and escape. There was one escape that happened while that was going on. It was actually KP, who was able to TP himself away from Universe. So you force the Titan to go all the way back, and we actually have the lane change up. So Howl will TP down to the bottom lane. They move him away from that Huskar. Now the Huskar is about to crack level 5.
Yeah, he needed the solo XP. The just supports up there aren't really going to do too much for him, as both Dazzle and Elder Titan, no sort of disables between the two of them, at least reliable ones anyways, as the Echo Stomp is something that you shouldn't fully rely on too much.
Do you actually want to move Poppy down the bottom lane? Like, should Secret rotate with Nubi and try and keep that Gyro under pressure?
I think you're in an okay position right now. The Darkseer is getting so much out of this lane, as is. You've got 39 CS. Downside is that the Tidehunter gets free farm too, but that's something that you sort of expect in this kind of matchup. As Arteezy is going to pick up the top rune, Universe gets the bottom one, and if they want to make this rotation mid, they know that Mu doesn't have that dragon form yet. They're going to try to go for the sandwich.
He's got help though, because KP's here, Universe. Okay, KP started the Ravage animation, but he will not complete it.
Yeah, just fakes that one.
This just seems so brutal, like the last 6 runes have actually gone to Team Secret.
They're just making it a priority to shut them out, because you have 2 bottles. And Wisp especially relies on runes more than almost any other hero. You can't do anything with an empty bottle Wisp. You're actually just a ball of light.
It's almost like you're reaching the point where Wisp just goes back to base, TP's forward, and then you use the bottle manipulation with Mu.
Yeah, that's right? What he has been doing. But you get underleveled that way. You don't really feel the impact sometimes. He is level 4 because he is dual laning, but at the same time, your mid lane suffers as a result. He's a full level behind the DP. He can't really leave him behind either anymore because Mu just gets gone on. We're going to see mid, both supports standing behind Arteezy, but shouldn't really have to worry too much as Chuan's pulling bottom, and Howl has shown himself too.
It's almost like they're just trying to like balance out the lanes, and everything is still fairly balanced until like Arteezy does something like this. It forces the mid lane, there's no fortification, so Mu just going to quickly dragon form and tail, getting Arteezy into a little bit more of a riskier position. And Chorn also gonna arrive. In comes Kaka. The Ravage gonna blow. Chorn lines up for the double stun, catching Puppy out at the same time. They need more damage though, and they just don't have it. They're fighting underneath the ultimate, the Exorcism, and now in comes Hal with a flat cannon damage. Moo will stay alive thanks to Kaka, and that's easy. He is gonna go down. He actually doesn't get to the end of the Exorcism, so no extra alive coming back into him. And Puppy can't even get his stomp off. She'll actually trade off a 2-for-1 with the Tidehunter going down. Newbie, but you've just lost your mid, your big mid as well.
That was so good by Newbie right there. You saw Chuan block off the Darkseer too. That would have been a dead gyrocopter, and that would have been a good trade for Secret, as they already napped the mid tower. Use the Tidehunter ultimate, which is a lot of what was stopping Team Secret from getting ultra aggressive around the map, but any sort of 2-for-1 trade is always going to be okay. It's just that you had to expend cooldowns and a lot of different TPs. And during this time, Eternal Envy just got free farm.
Yeah,
so Newbie's happy because they killed the Death Prophet, but Secret's happy because they forced a lot of ultimates and they allowed their Huskar to continue to get farmed. And it doesn't really slow down the pace of the DP too much. You realize she still has 3,800 net worth, leads the game, no problem. Darkseer's getting a lot too. So all three cores are really starting to get quite a lot as Moo mid.
There's no more Spirit Siphon.
Oh.
There was, he probably would have been in a world of hurt.
They do know about this, and he has a Spirit Siphon up. KPS to actually run away.
I'd be a little bit concerned about this top lane, waiting for Chorn to actually be initiated on by EE. Support's arriving in the form of the Dazzle.
Yeah, I don't think he has... Don't you just stun, and then Hex, and run away?
You should be able to do that, yeah.
Yeah, he doesn't have any follow-up initiation, it's just a Dazzle up here. Puppy showing himself on the map as his universe.
And Hal doesn't really care if Universe and Puppy want to try and go on him. Like, yeah, he's probably going to take a little bit of damage, but... Okay, maybe he'll care more when Arteezy moves over.
Yeah, this is just... a bit of poking and prodding. Set up for the rune in 30 seconds, too. Whole lot that he can do mid. Without the tower available, he's just got to wait for the lane to push in. Heavy rotation as Newbie start to make their way across, but Newbie...
The Observer Ward actually gives them great vision of what's going on, and they'll see the fact that Eternal Envy just TP'd down here. And Obs gives a hell of a lot of information.
They just beelined away from him.
Yeah, but you got Hal, who's already leaving the lane. You don't have Finger of Death yet over on Chuan, so they can't get an instant kill. They're hoping for a moment on Arteezy. But it's bottom lane where Hal's going to get caught out first, down inside the tree line.
There
but then
be
back
TV.
To mid, the relocate's coming in with KP. Arteezy will drop, they blow the Ravage to hit Highlight die as well. They'll get a 2-for, even if they do lose their safe laner in Hal.
Yeah, that was such an awkward engagement. They were going to make their way bottom, they see the Huskar immediately. They're just like, no, this is not
Keep dodging. He's got armor he wants to fight. I'm surprised Hal didn't back up a lot earlier.
Yeah.
Because he stuck around to farm the wave.
It was so funny how they swerved like that though on the map. They're just like, nope, that's not what we wanted to do at all. But, yeah, it is surprising that they knew Eternal Envy was down there, so they make their rotation otherwise. Hal knows there's going to be no support because they're all inning on that DP mid, and yet he chooses to stay down there. Absolutely cannot afford for that to happen.
Just pushes him a little bit further back behind in the net worth, but they can start claiming some buildings that Newbie can pick back up, because right now, Team Secret, they own the top three net worth positions, with the Tidehunter only just now taking out that third spot from them.
Yeah, he
and
just
the
continues.
Ties building into that mech early on too. So Secret's teamfight's gonna be a little bit more difficult once that's up and running.
Secret have to kind of push the pace. They know there's gonna be no counter initiation with something like the relocate into Tidehunter ultimate, which I don't think the Death Prophet expected. And at bottom, they know he's down there. They might actually just go for the dive with Eternal Envy.
Yeah, there it
they
is.
No, there's no TP.
Surge him up. The support's coming in, the cooldown's on his way, EE. Well, he's gonna run into the last bit of the cooldown, and Hal, he does almost no damage to Gyrocopter. Moo, however, stunning up Universe, there's no instant back into a wall, but now it comes out. Hal will drop, the Lion of Chorn will join him, and KP will arrive, but he's coming in almost a little bit too late. Kaka also relocated himself down into this one. They need the kill on Eternal Envy, but the Shallow Grave from Pylite die, allowing Envy to fight a little bit longer, but there's that mech charge. Eternal Envy will be dropping here. Radiant structure. They're able to, well actually KP, oh no! He had five charges of the Burning Spears on him, he was never gonna live from that.
Yeah, Eternal Envy just mows down three heroes and... Okay, somebody didn't send Hal the memo, like you're not gonna fight against a Huskar. That was just kind of sad.
Maybe he thought everyone else was going to come. Like, I think the reason why the IO
they
also
did.
Also didn't come straight away. They didn't come straight away. Like, IO TP's in behind the tower. KP comes in after Hal was dead.
There's just so much. There's just only so much that you can do. And it wasn't even like it was a full five-man secret rotation. It's just Gengar against Gyrocopter. That's sometimes just what happens. Yep. That's what it looks like if you were curious. That's why Secret decided to last pick it, because even though you have some physical damage counters with obviously the Tide Anchor Smash and the DK right click, doesn't do a lot when Huskar can destroy your safe laner. You saw Hau got everything off. He got his call down, he was rocket barraging at close range, went down in 5-6 hits.
They really need to get rid of that Berserker's Blood, and that's when I look towards Mu. He's already walking around with a Shadow Amulet, so more than likely, like, Silver Edge Rush. Can you get away with that with the DK? Like, obviously Silver Edge is, just Shadow Blade is a normal item on the DK currently, just for initiation purposes.
I sort of think he needs a... Well, BKB's not gonna be an absolute priority, right? I'm trying to think. Kind of like for him to get an armlet of his own at some point. He needs some cheap damage. I do like the Shadow Blade though against a lot of Secret heroes. They need to be able to open up on some of them. It would make it so that Pylite Dai has to play his positioning a lot more carefully too. Mm. Good news for Newbie though is that their two supports are really leveled compared to the two on Team Secret. You just grab your level 6 on Puppy, Pylite Dai is in a pretty abysmal situation at just level 5, as he has to act as kind of the saving grace for Secret in a lot of these engagements.
The only downside is the fact that Sean's ulti does almost no damage to Eternal Envy.
It's whatever. To worry about that.
He can look for another target. Maybe he can also control the Darkseer, but you also look at Universe's, like, items. Top net worth on the field, already with a Hood of Defiance, and as well as the mech.
Yeah, that's a smoke, though, from Newbie. They want to take this engagement around their Ravage. They don't want to get this game going way too late, just because, again, Gyro against Huskar.
Oh, Universe is going to break the smoke. The Dire Observer was there. Eternal Envy. He wants to dive in with a life break, but he's already hexed up. The armlet's on. He's got 15 one-shots for the Shellac Grave. And a back wall.
Earth Splitter.
It's huge. And the Splitter. Eternal Envy will just survive for this. Oh, no, he won't. He'll go down. Hau, they actually managed to regather themselves with the help of the Ravage. Then Envy, okay, he's going to fly back. They feel like they need to commit to win this engagement. RTZ still got the Nexism going to work. Chorn wants to keep him in position. KP's going to TP out. Universe does not have a fact to stop it. It's going with Arteezy. Can he actually reach him? He just looks so damn slow with just these treads on. And Kaka will tether away. The stomp will put him into sleep, but Universe will break him out of it. Kaka up to the tree line. He will now drop, and Chuan will also have the same fate. But you managed to get a buyback over on the Huskar Secret.
There's, no Rosh.
Are they bearing down on Roshan?
You have to. You use the buyback on Eternal Envy. You know there's no Ravage. Relocate is still up, but Ravage is the big spell there. And they just had no way of helping Envy up there. Like, they had the vacuum into Earth Splitter combination, but they used everything to ensure that Eternal Envy was going to go down there. Wasn't even able to pop his wand in that engagement. Goes for the buyback to ensure that Newbie can't fight back, but especially me, I underestimated how much they were going to be able to heal.
Moose going to pop the Dragon Form. There's a sentry down already. The relocate going to bring everyone else back to the front lines. Roshan flow over the backs. Again, there's no wall combo. Moose dropping down very, very low, but Eternal Envy, he's just so damn low. But again, the Shadow Grave. Pylite Dai from inside the Roshan. He's able to keep him alive. KP back to the front lines. The relocate out. You've actually got one for one trade off at the moment. Roshan still licking his wounds at 730 life. Chuan just needs to get himself away from this. He'll turn for the one stump. The damage from Arteezy is not enough, but it will be enough from Puppy Stomp. Keeping the spirit on top of Newbie. They go back in to finish the job. They look towards Roshan. No cooldown available. The buyback comes out from Chuan. They're trying to make Secret think twice. With no Exism, the damage won't be as much. The stomp at least keeps KP in position. And the splitter tries to affront with the back wall combo. Hits beautifully. The damage still is enough. Kaka, okay, it will be. Now TZ finds the double. Hau isolating up against Universe, who wants to walk back through the wall. Roshan is still alive. Universe is getting out, but Newbie is on the way. Chuan is back to the front lines.
They don't want to give up this Aegis. They know it's really low. Puppy, though, trying to guard it. Moves back alive. Everybody from Secret, though, they have to lick their runes and run away. Eternal Envy's going to TP down.
Hau thought they were still in there.
Oh, that stun is going to delay up Mu even longer. And Roshan might just be too tanky for Newbie. I think they have to disengage from this.
He's back.
Yeah, they're going to have relocate in 10 seconds, though, and the Ravage is coming soon. But that's going to be way too late. And Secret walk away with a good fight as Puppy and Universe hook up for that combo. The vacuum wall into that Earth Splitter did so much damage.
For a moment, I thought that we were going to survive. Like Kaka, he still had another two bottle charges once he got out of the stun. But he just can't repair that damage quick enough. Now Chuan also in a little bit of trouble. The stomp not instantly coming out from Puppy. He's almost playing around with Chuan at the moment. And a relocate is on the way. They'll look towards Universe, bringing Hau along with him. Kaka, is there? Well, there is actually a Shadow Grave still available. And Universe triggering off his mech. And Finger of Death, he's still got 7 stick charges as well, makes a break for the tree line. The flag cannon will not be enough damage, he waits longer before he'll trigger off these stick charges. Now it happens with a combo heal from Pylai Dai. Universe keeps running, but it's not far enough away. The stomp from Puppy, just a fraction of a second too late.
Yeah, but Arteezy might be going down here as heals is up the Dragon Knight, as he's just going to run away, but in some cases, I think they could have won that fight even harder. Eternal Envy forgot to... the wand, and if you notice, I think he actually turned the armlet off when the Tidehunter went for the anchor smash, so that's why it looked like the Tide did a 600 damage anchor. But still, fight goes for Grit's Way just because they pick up the last hit on the Aegis, and more importantly than that, they're really bringing the fight to Newbie. We talked about how Newbie really relies on getting the map control, winning these mid-game team fights, and then just kind of starving you out and taking objectives one at a time.
Yep.
But Secret with the Dire side, bring the fight to them every single time, and even with the Ravage up, they're not afraid to take these. And I think this is the right idea with how you're going to fight into a team like Newbie. You have to pick superior team fight, you have to get a really good laning phase off, and you got to maneuver around their large ultimates.
So far, Seeker have been doing a pretty damn good job. They actually held a 5k net worth and a 3k experience advantage, but just the way things have been going recently is starting to curve back in favor of Newbie. Look for the next major items arriving. Like, the DK is getting a hell of a lot more farm. He actually picks up the Ogre Club now, so it's not the old style build of Silver Edge. Obviously, that got changed.
So it looks like
it looks like he's going to go for a BKB.
Yeah.
If he forgot about it, then that's just really sad for Moo.
Nah. I doubt it.
Yeah, it would be unlikely.
Although, BKB, I guess he can start the Titan Stomp and the Vacuum. There is a lot of physical damage on the side of Secret. More than anything, you can also stop the Burning Spears, which is a large part of where the damage is coming from right now.
Well, that's his item of choice. Not finding any initiation. Secret have actually already prepared a nice little wall of observers, which see any kind of entry into their own jungle. So they know when they have to rotate out, and that's probably also the other reason why Eternal Envy, now with Dragon Lance in hand, is just pushing out the bottom lane with the babysitting of Pylai Dai.
Yeah. Good pickup from him. Kind of gives you everything you need. Better item than drums in this situation. Just needed all-around stats to be able to survive. Secret going to go for this two-man smoke.
Well, they still have an Aegis the Immortal they want to capitalize with. At the moment, all they're doing is just, well, farming. And they've got 2 minutes left on the Aegis.
Yeah, they've got to make something happen soon. And it looks like they want to invade back into their own jungle. They have full vision of where Newbie are at right now. Of course, you don't want to engage into one of these heroes as
they just DK. Saw Moo go invis.
Yeah, they're going to pick up off here. Do they have any
They have detection? No detection.
Nope.
Poppy doesn't have it. In fact, none of the supports actually have detection. There's 2 sentry wards flying out in the curry at the moment.
Okay, they really need vision up here. They still see Kaka, though. This ward has been really effective for them. It should tip them off to the fact that Newbie might have a ward in their own jungle, too, though.
The Secret are going to force things down the mid. Criticism is up, so it wouldn't be too difficult for Arteezy just to push down the mid lane. At the same time, Chorn's already attacking into the top lane. He's got a little bit of help behind him, so this may just be a straight tower trade. Hal, with the cooldown, will slow down this push from Team Secret. Arteezy tries to just force him out a little bit more. The cooldown actually doing very minimal damage to the creep wave. And the TPs are already starting. Puppy's coming up to the top lane. Be interested to see if they bring anyone else. With a fortification up, it's not going to be the easiest thing to finish off this tower. The stomp from Puppy will come, and here starts the TPs. With the split of Kaka, it's right on the line for this. It'll snap him back. Wants to get himself out of here, but he cannot do it in time. The relocate, he could have brought Moo with him. But the tower still goes down to the Dragonite. Moo makes a break for the tree line. So you lose your IO, but you ensure the kill on the tower. And Jara then denies the mid tier 2 as well.
Yeah, at the same time, you also had to commit the Death Prophet ultimate just take that tower mid. They didn't even get the last hit on it. They weren't able to take a team fight after that fact. Yeah, you lose the IO, but that's a level 9 IO. Not a lot gained by Secret is. Maybe we just continue to split up the map a little bit more, farm around the map more efficiently too. And you're starting to see that reflected in both the XP and the net worth as it starts to curve up in favor of Newbie. And Secret, even though they've got the objective advantage, mind you, they still did take the Roshan and they have their bottom tier 1 tower alive. It's Newbie that are just farming around the map a little bit more.
Yep. It's almost like they're just denying Eternal Envy the ability to do whatever hell he wants. Like, he's got a wonderful fighting build early on, but ever since he's reached that point, like, Secret almost have to force the fights. And yeah, as we saw, like, you trade a tier 2 for a tier 2, you can't force it.
Also, probably the bigger thing is the Dazzle just hasn't been able to get anything. He's more or less just sitting behind Eternal Envy, waiting for situations where he gets gone on to get that last second grave off. But when you do that, yeah, your Huskar is going to be in a much better position, but at the same time, you're never going to find individual farm for yourself.
Alright, so Team Secret, they still at least hold one out of the top three net worth positions, but the Gyrocopter and the DK are moving up very, very rapidly. Moves BKB, now 450 gold away. Time is just flying for him.
Yep.
And the Gyrocopter, he actually went in for a Dragonlance before finishing up his own BKB. I say finishing, he also needs to get the full Mithril Hammer before he finishes his BKB.
I believe he thinks that he has to be able to just hit from further away to play the positioning game against Huskar. And the BKB, it's helpful, but he needs some measure of damage and tank. The BKB is going to be huge for him, though. It's going to allow him to kind of hit the Huskar without just melting.
Yeah.
Before, what would happen is Eternal Envy is like, please hit me.
That almost puts more pressure on Arteezy, right? Like, if the Exorcism doesn't start doing a lot of physical damage.
Yeah.
Like, the BKB is just negate a large portion of the hits.
Especially since Spirit Siphon doesn't go through the magic community anymore like Radiant's it used to, which meant DP would scale even later into the game. But in this kind of situation, Secret, they want to take fights. Part of the issue is they don't really have the best disables on their team. They rely pretty heavily on that vacuum into ET stomp combo.
Yeah.
But not a whole lot of ways to lock them down. You notice that, especially in the fights where Eternal Envy gets gone on. They just sort of watch him die, because what are you going to do? Once you've expended the vacuum in the ET stomp, you don't have any more disables. You could Dual Scepter somebody, I guess?
You also have Dazzle help out, but Dazzle can't seem to stand anywhere near the front lines without dying almost instantly.
Yeah. You have one unreliable stun.
And Hao is really trying to force Secret to come home. And he's managed to get at least one back. Again, Puppy will be the first one to TP in. If he can get the Spirit and Stomp out, they would have an opportunity here against Hao, but Hao's already finished his TP. He only takes about 100, well, actually a little bit more than that, about 300 life off that tier 3 tower.
He was super efficient though, up there. He got a lot going there.
Yeah, she finished his BKB and still has 1400 gold up his sleeve.
Yep, disassembles.
It's like Newbie have perfectly thralled this game until they're at a point where they know they can fight. And Team Secret were so grouped up that actually this experience graph is almost looking like it's had a team fight happen. Like, you've gone up by a good 2k experience in favor of Newbie in just the last minute. Getting so much out of this map, even Chorn with a Blink Dagger as well as that level 2 Finger of Death. I'm very concerned for Pylodai's safety now.
Pylodai has to be the man of the match. His positioning in these fights are gonna have to just be masterful. There's a lot of different ways that they can gap close on this team. And again, like we talked about, one unreliable stun on the side of Secret, and that's gonna be the ET stomp. So if he just gets ran at, not a whole lot that they can do to commit to save him. It's gonna be the initial fight. Whatever Secret can burst, that's going to be the most important for them. They have to get their combo off. They're going to stand a chance at taking a straight up 5v5 fight against things like the Ravage, against the Lion.
There's smoke moving down to bottom lane. The Dragon Form was triggered pretty early here by Mu. He's now in range of the tower. He did it because he actually just farmed up the ancient stack of Team Secret.
Positioning.
Here they come. Where is the movement? Arteezy wants forward. Envy, who do you want to jump on? He's going to go over towards Mu. You've still got Karkar in a position where he can potentially relocate. Save that. Then they move forward with Hao. Chorn, they isolate Eternal Envy.
The Ravage
making it difficult. Now the Ravage will pop.
Oh, he dodges
Envy
it.
And holding him there for the moment. And now the back wall will happen. The Meg and the Splitter. Kaipi, he's actually moving far enough away, but no, he's not. Puppy's there waiting with open arms. Two heroes down for Nubi. They're just trying to bail out of here. That was not the fight they were looking for, but it's still a 2-for-1 trade-off.
KP looks for the counter-initiation, but immediately gets clipped, uses the Ravage, the Death Prophet dodges it with the Yule Scepter, making it completely useless. Now you're in a situation where you're gonna have to give up the Roshan, you don't have the Ravage available, Relocate is still there, but without the Ravage, no way that you take that fight. In Secret, that's exactly what they needed. The biggest thing is, again, Ravage was wasted. DP gets his Yule Scepter off at the last second, right as the tick starts to hit. Secret read that situation beautifully. It looked for a second like maybe we were just going to stomp that fight, but...
Instead, the Secret who comes out on top and the Aegis the Immortal will be passed over to Eternal Envy. So again, EE having more and more life. The Octarine now fully done over on Arteezy as well. Looks like Eternal Envy.
Did you say Kaipi, by the way?
I think I did say that in the middle of the fight.
I
Bring it back to memories, bro.
Mm-hmm. There's no memories, man. They're a team again. Don't say that, man. That's messed up.
I'm sorry.
That Dazzle Grave plus the self fuels really good individual plays, and Newbie, they definitely did not expect to lose that bottom fight.
No.
That was something I think they thought heavily go in their favor, especially with no BKBs on the side of Team Secret. It just looked like that was going to be a stomp for them. Dragon Knight had his BKB popped, the Gyrocopter was also in the thick of things. We had a lot of different opportunities to take that fight.
It just seems to have to go so deep to reach the back line of Team Secret. Puppy is holding them back so far with that spirit. Even just jumping forward, if you're going to do it, you're going to commit yourself almost to suicide. But Chuan, like, he focused on Eternal Envy at the very start. And you can see him, like, he wanted the Finger of Death. But what are you going to do? Finger of Death on Huskar, who's already at half of his life? That's...
Commit, man. Show him you have no fear.
That's one way to look at it.
Tell him you don't respect his... Berserker's blood.
That's why I'm still waiting for this Silver Edge. And Mu, this is actually the timing we're looking for. So he's got enough money now, or practically now, where he's going to be picking up the Ultimate Orb. So the Silver Edge is up for him.
Yeah,
That's when Eternal Envy, like, with the first reveal of this, EE may just pop. But he's also got Nagus the Immortal, so first reveal may not be as effective as they would hope.
Also, he just finishes BKB. Mu probably thinks he's being so cool. You know why he does that anyways? Because every single core player hates going BKB. Eternal Envy, whenever I see him play Slark, he's like, I'll go Manta before I get a BKB, and jump is made as, does he have enough damage? The answer is
yes.
Emphatically yes. BKB's gonna get clipped by this. Gonna force staff, but...
He has the blink as well. Let's just get him away from the spirit so he can get out, and away from the vision of Arteezy's Yule Scepter.
Yeah. But every core player, you don't want to get a BKB, but Eternal Envy's like, why not? And as soon as he does, picks up the Silver Edge.
It's kind of brutal for Mu, too. Like, that fight on bottom lane may have been very, very different. Thank you, Kaka.
Kaka's going to tell them when the Aegis is down.
if he had the Silver Edge a little bit earlier, maybe that bottom fight could have been a little bit different, but it's a lot of what-ifs.
Yeah, the BKB, you saw pay dividends. The Huskar wasn't dealing any damage in the beginning, because the Burning Spears is where the majority of that comes from, but...
You don't take damage, but you can't inflict damage.
Yeah. Alright, here we go.
Now they smoke maneuver.
Take two.
Hal's already pushing out that bottom lane, attacking into the tier 2 tower. The fact that no one's here to defend this has got to be a warning bell for Newbie. And they actually find Mu in the river. Question is, yep, they brought detection. Universe at the dust, and Mu just BKBs and TPs out to safety.
That's a second charge used, though. Good news for Newbie is their Gyrocopter is leading in net worth. Bad news for Newbie is that he's a gyro still against
the Huskar. The bad news is KP will actually, yep, now he TPs. That stomp was out of range. He wasn't sure about it, though. He really wasn't sure about it.
The way that Newbie wins this game is they have to kill everybody or just completely crowd control up Eternal Envy. Otherwise, I don't even know if they can do that anymore with that BKB purchase. But you're going to have to give it a good shot.
Well, the only other option is you have Chuan jump in and get that Hex off first.
Yeah.
So the BKB is effectively removed.
Thing for Newbie, though, is, again, Secret are a little bit limited in disables. So the more this game goes, the more they can play the mobility game. So hard, you can tell, for Secret to get individual pickoffs. Like, when's the last time you saw Team Secret get an individual pickoff? It was that Wisp at top, and that's he was completely isolated. But if you think about the rest of the game, there hasn't been. It's only been these huge 5-on-5 clashes. So you kind of read what Secret want to do. They want to force Newbie to kind of confront them. And Newbie are trying to say, no, let's play the keep away game, continue to let our Gyrocopter get farmed. Maybe if he gets 6 slotted, he can fight against this Husk.
Yeah. Kind of needs to have like a physical damage dealing item first. Like, that's the only other way to get through that Huskar. Start teasing. They're going to force the issue right now. Pushing up high ground. Sentry's dropped just in case anyone wants to have a nice ward to see where Newbie are positioning before the fight begins.
Thanks to Kaka, though, everybody now knows when the Aegis falls.
Eternal Envy. They're going to wait it out. That Aegis Immortal is still on him. Envy is low.
KP,
a 5-man Ravage. The Splitter rather ineffective. And Hal moving forward. You've got to keep your eyes on Eternal Envy. He's jumping forward for KP, actually leaving the rest of his teammates behind, including Arteezy, who will drop the Darkseer back wall. Was able to make a little bit more space, they get through the range ranks, and EE back to the front lines again, and there it is, the Aegis Immortal is gone, they waited it out, and EE, the Shallow Grave from Paladai, positioning perfect, EE wants to keep on fighting, the stun from the rocket is going to be enough, the stomp from her puppy can't make enough space, they're going to lose both their primary pushing cores here, Secret. So newbie defend, and they're already on the hunt. Kjorn is moving forward, but he's got to be careful. They find Pylai die, and Pylai die dead. What a barrage. He really has nothing. And Chuan and Kaka, they relocate him forward. Puffy, no, the stunner, it's going to stop him. The Dragon Tail arrived just in time. He was ready to punch Kaka, but he couldn't finish the job. Oh boy, that's a cost. That's a costly fight for Secret.
Yeah, and they only grab range tracks out of that too. If it was a melee one, I think they might even walk away happy from that, but...
They didn't even force a buyback. Like, with 30 minutes in, newbie didn't have to expend any extra money for it.
Yeah, Secret thought they weren't going to continue to take the fight after the Ravage, but we talked about it to death. They have a lot of different ways to engage the fight.
Yep.
It's not like Secret's lineup where they rely so heavily on one or two abilities. They have lots of different ways to chase out. Even their cores, for example, like Mu can hunt with the Silver Edge. You saw the application of it in this last team fight. Eternal Envy had to use the BKB before the Aegis ran out, meaning he didn't have it when he came back alive, and they took him to bits.
Fun times for Hao, so he's going to make the most out of the new Dota 2 items. The Bloodthorn looks to be his item of choice, currently walking around with the Orchid.
It's actually not bad against the Huskar once he starts to lose a lot of that effectiveness from the BKB. All the crits, right? There is a BKB on the side of Huskar. I guess you just kind of have to kite around. You're going to rely on that fact. If you can waste a lot of this BKB charges, once it starts to get down to 5 seconds, you're going to see how effective it can be.
I'm actually wondering too, not so wondering. Yeah, the DK has already got a Hyperstone on him.
He needs the armor to help out against the Huskar.
The AC armor. And Kaka also having his pipe up and running.
They are getting really tanky.
Yeah.
After that last fight at top 2, net worth. Experience especially really picks up.
Experience is huge. How gonna BKB and TP himself out? Nothing Envy can do about this. These BKB charges are dropping down lower.
Yeah.
So there's 7 seconds now left over on the gyrocopter and 7 seconds on the DK.
They really need to win the next Roshan fight, Secret. That's gonna be where the next big engagement's gonna be. There's no way that Secret decide to fight without it, especially with the Silver Edge up on the side of the Dragon Knight. You wanna be able to use that BKB a little bit more greedily on the side of Eternal Envy. Plus, with these mini engagements, you're forcing out a lot of BKB charges on the side of newbie.
Could be a big reason why Kaka's prepping his observer wards already around Roshan.
Yeah.
So they can see Team Secret just running at him.
Why wouldn't you fight at that? You know, if they grab it, Secret are immediately going to go for the high ground.
Looks like EE, the Talisman of Evasion over on the Courier, is the full Shiva's Guard now also done for the Death Prophet. Attack. Kind of forget how big Arteezy is, but he's the second highest on the net worth charts. Hao still leads the way.
Hao's just been farming. Whenever his team is holding the base, he's just split pushing, trying to get as much as he can. As a result, the rest of the heroes on Secret just haven't been able to keep up because they're a lot more 5-man oriented, of course. But Roshan's going to be the name of the game as it pops up. They do have Ward Vision around that area. This is going to be the Aegis and Cheese. Quite huge for Team Secret, as we know DP with a Cheese. One of the best heroes with it, of course.
See if she can get her hands on it, however. Snoopy now, the Assault Cuirass is done. They're already pushing in the mid lane. Like, the only lane which isn't really favorable for them right now is over on the bottom. He's actually finished up the full Heaven's Halberd before this fight will begin.
There's going to be no BK or MKB on the side of newbie for quite some time. With the commitment of this Assault Cuirass, but
the Bloodthorn just got done too.
Yeah, exactly.
So it slows down the MKB on the gyrocopter.
Okay, Universe is going to send the illusions forward to scout. He should be able to spot some heroes from newbie.
Yeah, she scouts the observer wards. He's got a gem over on himself, so
they're even going to pop the scan. They know everybody's up here. Spirit's going to fly and the smoke. He knows.
They're walking through the spirit. Yeah, Puppy pinged it out. He knows what's going on. But he's inside the pit. He's going to walk himself out now. Secret also have a little bit of extra buff up. They got that Ogre Frost Mage.
They can wait. They're
not waiting. They smoke. Moon walks directly into him. Breaks it. They go directly on top of Puffy. Remove his aura. And now the Ravage from KP. Hitting on 3. Eternal Envy. No real presence in this fight just yet. The Yule Scepter from the Death Prophet. Brings her up and towards the air. But the Finger of Death instantly puts Arteezy down. And Moon just goes for more. KP with the Anchor Smash. Pylon's going to drop the back wall. Try to create a little bit more space. But they got the BKB stuff anyway. So Eternal Envy. Man fighting. It is 5 on Envy right now. He is the meat in this Secret Sandwich.
He's holding.
He's just surviving. He's actually holding on. They can't hit.
hit him!
Did he actually just win this fight?
Yep, they just did! KP attempts to TP out, he'll be successful!
Unbelievable!
He'll survive in the face, but man! EE!
Come on, we reacted as if this fight was over for Secret.
Well, it looked over!
It was Eternal Envy against the world. He goes full Terminator mode, holds the line, says, "You shall not pass." The entire team makes their way over with the puppy buyback. What a fight by them.
Oh boy.
That might have just saved the game.
Get the Roshan.
He was able to just 1v4. Just walks away. Everybody from Newbie's desperately trying to ping this guy down. They lose both their cores in that engagement.
Oh boy. They just couldn't hit him. Like, was it missed chances? Was it also, like, did he break the silver at just some point?
They just couldn't. It was the Heaven's Hovered combined with the fact that he was healing. The majority of the BKBs were used, so he was getting a lot of damage out of there. They didn't have any of their burst nuke controls or anything like that. The stuns were a little bit more stacked than they would have liked. Oh boy, I really thought Newbie was going to have that fight. That looked so perfect for them. They got the control factor up on the Death Prophet. They really made that work. I thought Newbie, okay, they've continued their streak. They've knocked Secret down a little bit. But that was just cool Dota.
Really was. I still can't believe this Newbie with a 10k experience advantage at this game.
Yeah, I was calling that fight. I was already getting in my mind prepared for why Newbie won that fight. I was like, I was going to talk about how they caught BP off guard. Then all of a sudden, Eternal Envy's just like 1v4ing the
whole time. Oh, Secret Eternal. Come in. Arteezy very, very deep. Again, the finger of death will kill him off. Just had no time to react, and Secret wanted to. Like, they started the weave 2 seconds before that fight began. They're trying to build up the armor, but they were just very... Well, I won't say premature into the base.
That was so funny. We're just talking about how they're gonna win the engagement. They're going up high ground, and then he immediately just gets blown up.
We're actually swinging the caster curse stick.
Yeah. Who used the force staff onto the DP? Because that's what really did it.
It's Chuan. That was Chuan.
Yeah, you're right. She used force debuff from Lion. This is very well played by Chuan. If he doesn't get that one off, Secret can probably hold and help him out. You pop the Grave onto the DP, then she pops Cheese. Up at full HP again, you're fighting under DP ultimate, but instead Newbie, really well done by them.
I still find it amusing that it was Puppy who actually picked up the Aegis the Immortal after all that happened.
Did he?
They're in no peril to like put it on anyone else. Eternal Envy held on to all of his current items as opposed to taking the Aegis.
And to be real with you, the Elder Titan is doing so much in these engagements, being able to get multiple man stomps off. Obviously, you want to keep him around for the spear plus the natural order.
Yep.
That's going to be what enables Secret to do a lot of that damage, but they have to protect their cores. Still really liable to just get immediately blown up in a lot of these engagements.
Maybe a little bit more difficult than these in the next engagements. KP's rapidly approaching that refresher orb. So you can have double ravages for Team Secret to deal with. So a lot of control factors. You still haven't seen any kind of real progression there from Mu.
He's only got a 5-second BKB mid.
Mid lane, yep. There's room from Eternal Envy. He's just staring down how. He's gonna BKB and TP out, but the damage is more than enough to kill him before he can complete it.
No armor at all on how after that natural order walks by. There's no armor items on that gyrocopter. Look how quickly he goes down. Even with the BKB and no burning spears, he gets 4-shot.
He has to go to stand next to Mu.
Yeah.
There's that refresher done. He got buyback on the gyrocopter, so if Secret want to push this, which, well, kind of want to. Like, you've still got every ultimate up here from Team Secret, and you got 2 minutes left on the Aegis. So they start the weave a little bit earlier this time, so the armor, it starts to tick forward. Eternal Envy will be the front man runner. Mu hits him straight away. They really want that kill with a force staff again. Chuan's on top of him. Have they got enough to kill him off?
The Ravage.
Number one's gonna trigger. KP, now number two. That's 9 heroes in total hit
Eternal
by
Envy's
that.
Just not taking damage though.
The back wall is there. They'll send the DK up towards the air. Eternal Envy, shallow grave up as well. He'll finally trigger off that BKB running out. He's so low, but they can't finish the job. Mu force staffed away into the infis. He'll survive. Universe gonna get fingered down. There's still a one for one trade-off, but you've done both your Ravages. Kar can tether himself out too. The Team Secret on the front door, they bring down the tier 3 tower. The TBs are coming back. Newbie, they're not going to give this one up without a fight. Eternal Envy, however, is the only real target in the front lines. And now Mu, thanks to the stomp from Puppy. Well, actually, that doesn't really help him as much as Arteezy.
He got control up for a bit. Mood comes back in again. Hits on the turn of Lemby. He removes the passive with the thumb of the telegrade. Highlight Die is just sitting on the back lines. The uber medic right now, keeping Eternal Lemby alive until the DK can finally finish the job. The cooldown as well, slowing down Arteezy, has to burn the cheese and will be retreating. Nubi, they hold onto their rack and they're looking for more. Arteezy hexed up that initial stun initiation from Chorn. They move him into the tree line. Moves in the neighborhood too. You'll step the rub. Moo, he's waiting for the attack. Arteezy slipped his way through the tree line, but Chorn is back again with another stun. Arteezy just cannot get Chorn off his back, and he will be dropping down. Nubi defend their mid racks. Team Secret will be repelled.
Secret just couldn't kill anybody. Moo walks away after being silver edged, and even though Eternal Envy, it was some Herculean 5-man effort from Nubi, they eventually bring him down. It took 3 or 4 uses of the Bloodthorn and the Silver Edge to do it, but at the end of the day, they get the job done. They hold the racks. Cheese was popped too on Team Secret, yep. And that is just going to make Team Secret a little bit more careful for these next engagements, because they start to realize when you get up to high ground, you're going to have to run into the double Ravage. The same issue still exists. They have no real way to chase into the base. You see Chuan going absolutely insane in these fights with that Force Staff.
They may have a better tank next time though, because the Satanic is rapidly approaching for the Husker.
Yeah.
So once he's got that, like these saves which come in from Pylite Die can actually turn around to Husker going back to full life.
Yeah. This has got to be so frustrating for Team Secret. They, against most normal teams, that would be enough of an effort to win, but Nubi's just so good at spell usage. That's the thing. It's honestly just item and spell usage that's keeping them in this game right now. The double Ravage, yeah, they weren't able to get kills, but it locked down a lot of different heroes. He got 4 heroes in both of them. Same time.
It's like one way to try and stop Chuan from bursting down whoever the hell he wants. The Lotus Orb is now over on the Elder Titan. You're getting more evasion arriving through the Solar Crest, but at the same time, you look at the two items which are over on the DK, as well as the Gyrocopter, they're both holding on to Demon Edges at the moment.
Yeah.
And they're both like half away from having the double Javelins.
Darkseer is going to go for the Hex. That's going to solve a lot of their issues. We keep bringing it up, but it has to be said, just because that is kind of what's holding Secret back in these fights. They don't really have the best way to start any of these engagements after they use those major abilities. But now with the Hex available on Universe, things are going to get a lot easier for them. Yep. Especially if you look at the BKB timers on the side of the newbie. 5 seconds on both of them. So next Aegis might just be territory for them to fight. It's on Universe. Satanic on Eternal Envy. They are in tip-top fighting shape.
Yep. But then can Nubi dodge? Nubi still need more time. They need to finish up these Monkey King bars, and if they do finish them, like, your buyback's already on cooldown for the Gyrocopter, but DK will have his in 220 gold. Is the MKB worth sacrificing your second life? Especially when you're fighting from inside your own base.
Sort of think at least one of them should get it. They need one of their two deep damage dealers to be able to grab one. At the same time, you need the double buyback because it's very likely that Secret just decided to go for the Roshan and then try to take the game. Nubi might be in a position though, because they are a game up, just kind of change their thought process where they say, let's go for the win.
They're actually grouping up for a smoke maneuver. Barkar's on his way over as well.
You gotta check Roshan. That's the big thing for both sides.
He doesn't spawn for potentially another 20 seconds.
Yeah.
And that's only then the instant spawn.
There's no way that Secret decided to try to take a fight outside their base, and there's no way that Nubi just go for a direct engagement of their own. It has to be around this Roshan pit for both sides.
Actually, by giving Hal that bottom lane, he still needs the other creep wave. He's so close to having the MKB.
They're gonna farm it together as a team, but that might just open things up for Secret.
Oh,
they have
smoke.
A DD.
Wait, Hal breaks out of the smoke. The rest of them are here. The scan comes out from Nubi. It actually reveals the fact the Secret is there, so they are well aware the gank is on the way.
Do you really want to fight into that DD?
It is a big question mark.
They are just hightailing it, but that was one of their last smokes remaining. They still have one more to go. I think that's why they felt comfortable popping that one, Toby, because they said, okay, if this one fails, well, we've got another one coming up, and that's the one they need for the Roshan engagement.
250 gold for Hal. Okay, make it now none. He's got his MKB.
Yeah, I think this is the correct play. You play for the win.
The only downside is they don't have it yet on the DK. He's still short by 900, but they prioritized it over onto House. They had something that could deal with Envy directly.
House is very hard to kill in these engagements. He's got a lot of HP, a lot of armor. When the ET is pushed further back, he's in a nice spot to deal some damage out. Maybe the DK should have gotten it, actually. Dragonite's a lot harder to kill. Plus,
true.
He's got an AC of his own.
But if you also think about, like, after this next fight, like, if Nubi take this fight, they obviously don't really like gain a huge advantage in the game. Like they get control of the map back almost. Like if you can also get a butterfly over onto Hal, then he becomes the man the secret then can't kill.
Difference in XP earned 15k, a lot of that coming out of poor Dazzle. The net worth just showing you how close these teams are.
Yeah. It's almost like one of these graphs is lying to us. One of these things is not like the other.
They know they're smoked up. They also know that Newbie don't do Roshan fast enough. So Newbie's just going to disengage. But unfortunately for them, they wasted one of these smokes. And Hal has to deal with this top lane.
Yep.
I think that's going to be Secret's move now. Push out this mid lane. Force Newbie to play around Vision. And if they can get one more ward down around this mid area, then they can almost secure the Roshan for themselves. Especially with Newbie out of smokes.
The hilarious thing is this whole like movement from Secret and Newbie, it's taken so long, the Gyrocopter's buyback is almost off cooldown, but they may need him here right now. You can relocate in the Gyrocopter, Mu's already getting inside that Silver Edge Invis. He knows Secret are on the prowl. No one's showing in any of the lanes yet.
Secret know they've been spotted too. They're gonna push out this bottom lane, and what they're trying to do right now, Toby, is force the lanes in at all times so that they know when Newbie's gonna come take the fight. They know Newbie don't have smokes anymore. It's a reasonable guess because they use back-to-back ones, and nobody saves a third one at this phase of the game.
Anubi still also got the other advantage. The fact that their split push is more powerful thanks to the presence of the Io.
Yeah.
So he can always be sitting there with the Gyrocopter who mows down lanes. Now you've actually got time to get the second Monkey King bar over on Newbie. So they got direct attack on both sides. Secret, they are going to take Roshan now. Exorcism is triggered. As Radiant Vision goes, they do not see the pit, but they're well aware of what's going on.
They have a smoke in 1 second, okay. They're gonna bring over Helm of Iron Will. And Newbie, if they're gonna take this fight, it's gonna be in Vision. I don't think this is a fight that you wanna take.
Roshan's already gone. TZ's gonna take the cheese. Eternal Envy now has the Aegis the Immortal, dropping its treads in order to grab up this item.
This slow moving assault's gonna come down.
I suppose it makes it a lot easier to kite a Husker.
Indeed.
So he triggers off to the BKB and Satanic. You just back out. Don't let him attack anybody.
With that hex, though.
Good luck with that when you got ET as well as Darkseer.
Yeah, with the hex on Universe 2, it makes it a lot easier for him to gap close anyways. But Newbie, again, no smokes, can't take fights. Even if they had a smoke available at the last second, at that point, Secret were already done with the Roshan.
49-minute BKB is the item of choice from Arteezy.
He needs it against the double Ravage. He understands how fast he goes down. Plus, Chuana is just doing a number on him right now.
Chuana's also got he's got a lot of money. That's 2.8k over on the Lion. Like, one, yeah, you got buyback, but two, maybe you can even see like another disable item up against Secret.
He's a Lion with only 3 deaths. You've got to commend that. No. He's got the least on his team.
Secret again, preparing. The helm of the Dominator, Hal is going to convert one of the catapults to his evil claws. And Secret won't actually engage. I thought with the triggering of the weave from Dazzle, it was kind of like telegraphing the Secret one to go up. But instead, they're going to wait it out. They've already burned through just under a minute and a half worth of that Aegis timing.
Yeah, they still have a pretty good timing though. They're not in too big of a rush quite yet. Force out the lanes, push out bottom, make it so that if you do go for a push and you win the fight, you can just immediately take multiple wrecks.
I love seeing this kind of like item over on a DK. Just casual, late game, you got armor, you got direct attack, you got immunity, you got initiation. But how do I have sustain a casual Morbid Mask just sitting on this Dragon Knight?
Didn't he have the Helm of Dom component too?
Yeah, he did. I think it was both Hal as well as Mu who had one.
Yeah.
EE comes up, they Lotus
Orb,
so Mu stuns himself, Universe, Six-Pack jumping in, he hexed over on Mu with the 4-star, allowing Mu to disengage, fortification, waste a little bit of time here from Secret, Puppy, tries to create more time, he keeps KP on the back line. They've still got the BKBs up for Newbie, and yes, Secret, they're out, they didn't get what they wanted.
They use both there. I think the issue is that they hesitated for half a second on the jump on the DK. You saw that there was that moment of awkwardness where they're like, okay, he's stunned. Can we really kill him? But no, with the 4-staff from Chuan, gonna end any hopes of that.
So that is really this the time when Newbie attack? Like they got a smoke sitting right now on the Tidehunter.
It is still difficult to fight into their lineup. I guess you could go for one theoretically if you push out bottom. But you gotta clear out any ward vision that they could potentially have first too.
Well, there's only one aggressive observer ward up from Team Secret. And actually, Secret? Okay, they just showed themselves in the mid anyway. They are telegraphing their position, so Newbie just have to wait. If they wait just a little bit longer, then Secret will come to them.
Secret right now, just waiting for the next Death Prophet ultimate. There's absolutely no reason to wait the next, to not wait the next 40 seconds. You're also just going to wait for all the BKBs to refresh, which they have.
Aegis has 1 minute 40 seconds though.
Yeah, that is the scariest part right now of this engagement. Because they kind of have to hurry things up, but they don't want to go in pre-Arteezy ultimate, but at the same time, you really want to be able to utilize this Aegis on Eternal Envy. They already have trouble bringing him down the first time. Him having 2 lives might just enable them to go for the high ground, and here it comes.
Yep, they're on their way. They start up the weave. Howl, is it going to pop that call down nice and early and try and get rid of the creep wave? ET spirits out, looking for his early targets. Now it wastes a little bit longer. Damn, we got to keep watching that time. So they got 1 minute and 10 seconds left on the Aegis. But then they jump forward again. Mooga does self-stun, but Eternal Envy, he's also completely out of mana at the moment. Wants this Aegis the Immortal to trigger. He wants to soak up abilities. There's no creep wave on the front lines. Puppy can go for the stomp. Exorcism is available, but they're trying to use Eternal Envy as a buffer right now. And Envy, he just does it. He just goes for the racks. They're going to load us all up nice and quickly, and Envy down a low shell. Like Rave will keep him alive. He's still got that Aegis for another probably 40 seconds. He's so... Oh, he ticks out! Okay, that's maybe not part of the initial plan. And now Eternal Envy, the stun will be there. No Lotus Orb helping Universe. Vac Wall, he catches up Moo as well as KP. Moo will go into the early BKB. And KP, where is that Ravage? Currently, he's silenced. He can't get back into the fight. Arteezy brings the Exorcism to the front lines, and Envy's
gonna go for it.
One. There goes your Ravage, but the Yule Sword as well as the BKB. Second one more pop. Arteezy hit by that, and the Finger of Death. They bring down Arteezy to say goodbye to your Exorcism, but Eternal Envy still on the front lines. Universe there to help him with a splitter from Puppy. He'll create a lot of space. They need to start buying back. Lion's coming back in. They've already taken the melee racks. The top lane pushed in so hard that they actually took out 2 melee racks with just this push. Question is, can Secret get out scot-free? They lost Arteezy. But at this point, it's a sacrifice worth paying.
Highlight Eye almost had the angle on the grave, which would have enabled him to get that cheese off that he desperately needed to, but wasn't able to at the last second. Newbie had enough burst damage to bring him down, but still... Fight one, you bring down Mu, you bring down 2 of the melee rain, 2 melee racks. It's got 1 to go at this bottom lane. The range racks mid is relatively inconsequential.
Okay, at this point, you newbie, you're 2 lanes down. Do you just like sell something and get that rapier on the gyrocopter to make a beeline for the mid?
I don't know.
You've still got 90 seconds until the first drive. It just back up again. However.
Yeah, he's probably going to buy it, but.
There it is.
You really just go mid without your double Ravage? Or even at least a single Ravage? I think you wait. I think the Rapier is the choice in this game. Because even if Secret get it, I guess they would put it on Eternal Envy. That's the only hero that can hold on to it. Yeah. If they can control him up, maybe it's okay anyways. Point if he loses it, they might call it.
The issue for Howe is he's going to rely almost solely on Kaka to keep him alive.
Yeah.
Because he dropped Dominator in order to hold on to that Ravage.
I still am a big fan of Newbie. Play for the win. Doesn't matter what situation you're in, play for the win. Especially when you're still up a game and you can chance something like this.
Okay, looks like Envy's going to 6-slot himself. Fires a full Assault Cuirass. He doesn't have buyback because of this, however. He's short by about 600. But considering the last fights that have been happening by Envy, he's going to get 600 inside of it.
Yeah, this is... pretty unbelievable game, how back and forth it's been. Newbie being able to hold a line that I just simply didn't think they could.
I still cannot remember a time when I've seen a team so dominant, I say so dominant, in such a good position as Secret, when they were 17,000 experience behind.
Yeah.
Like,
I am, even with any sort of, there's no real leads in Dota. You can almost always break them, 15k, 10k, but probably the more important, impressive thing right now from Team Secret is they're not that much ahead in net worth, but they're still taking all of these engagements around the Aegis. That's just good Dota. Sometimes you see teams wait out until they have 10, 15k leads before they risk anything, but Secret are also playing for the win. They say, all right, we're going to fight around this Aegis timing no matter what, even into the double Ravage. There's still opportunities to win fights.
Newbie, a tense situation for him. Trying to prepare as best they can for the upcoming fight. Mu actually did complete up a Dominator now, so he did just convert the Morbid Mask. And a Berserk Ward from Secret, though, it's watching the movement of Newbie. Like, they know the Newbie went up to just farm up the Ancients. They're focusing primarily on the northern half of the map.
Newbie are just gonna rinse and repeat. Push out the lanes, wait for the next Roshan engagement, take that fight with the Rapier, your best shot. They just keep waiting for the next Aegis's. There's a good chance that Team Secret can just whittle away at your racks. And all it takes, again, with that Rapier picked up, is one fight to go right.
It's a longer spawn time, though, for Roshan this time around, so Secret will have to wait until just after the 2-minute mark, or they can take it. They're gonna be worrying about that gyrocopter. He's critting creep waves right now for 1100. If they do not respect Hal, he's just gonna shred apart Husker.
It's a minor concern.
just a minor one.
That Bloodthorn does a lot.
They do have a lot behind it as well, though. Like, when Dazzle's able to get the weave off, they have, like, an exorbitant amount of armor on Team Secret.
They're okay in this position anyways, just because Elder Titan is a hero that always scales. They're always going to take away a lot of that natural armor. Of course, it's going to be quite good against the DK, which is why Wu just built tons of armor items anyways. He's got plus 32 with him. So even if they get that natural order on top of him, he's in an RA position.
Puppy trying to keep that bottom lane out. Looks like Nubia just trying to get that little bit of extra cash, not to mention it is the last remaining out of tower on the map. Obviously, Nubia lost all of theirs a while ago.
Yeah, Secret don't want to take this fight.
They actually fortify when that town's at 12 HP. So the tower's still getting killed off by...
They're pinging. They want to take this fight.
Yep, Mu, however, they can't see him. He's inside the Silver Edge, and they don't have detection on the front lines. The gem is in the hands of the Darkseer, who we should also note has enough money to buy a full Refresher Orb, so that's double the Hex. Anubia have to come home. Their Tier 4 towers are currently under siege. And this is... you still got 1 minute until Roshan, so it's
they know.
As bad.
The relocate at top. They know this is going to be a 3v5 fight. They've got the angle, too.
How long we got left? Counted down for Kaka to arrive back in.
They're just
going
to
jump in. Eternal Envy stuns up. There's your BKB. KP jumps in. There's your first Ravage. Highlight die. Brought down by Moon. Puppy also zoned out this way. Artie's on the front lines, but he can't do enough damage.
How
as the Yule cover himself up. Now the Ravage will go again. Hitting on Puppy. Artie's in the finger of death. Can they kill him? The clap back. Kaka is still alive. He
How's
was
busting
him up. The buybacks are coming in. Kaka's alive. He's actually keeping Hal up as well. So Hal can come back in with a Rapier. They bring down Eternal Envy. 3 are down for Team Secret. All will have buyback, but it's at the same time as Roshan is alive, so they'll quickly try and grab this Roshan, the insurance on the gyrocopter, and the insurance for Nubi.
What am I watching?
Dota.
I can't even believe that KP has that patience. He presses the refresher, but he realizes, okay, all the BKBs are up. I'm gonna reset my position. Hal gets a little bit low. As soon as that happens, he jumps back in, catches both the cores with it. They immediately go down as a result of this rapier. Cheese sounds like it just immediately got eaten.
Yep.
And Kaka with that save too onto Hal. If they lost that rapier, that could have been disastrous for them, but he had 3 stacks of the Burning Spears, like 200 HP. Close, but the Wisp there.
Nubia's coming. Nubia's coming. You got an Aegis the Immortal. You've got a Divine Rapier on Hal. They're not all yet just yet there. You can bring KP if he buys like BTs and drags it out to himself, but it looks like Hal is going to force a little bit of an issue on the bot. Kaka can relocate him out if things get rough. And looks like the DK, okay, he'll complete a Satanic and they get a buyback out from Eternal Envy. Nubi will now disengage and just reset up.
And for the first time in a very long time, Nubi are in a winning position. They forced out the buyback from the Huskar, so all they have to do is kill him once in the fight to win. They still have 5.7k built up on how to go along with it. Probably going to drop the phase boots at some point too.
He's into that walking tank. He's just switching. He's switching between phase boots and the SMY he put back on the courier.
I think he knows he doesn't really need the mobility from either of those items anymore. He has a lot of control factors. He can just sit himself down and say, I'm just going to keep attacking with Flak Cannon. I'll catch somebody out at some point with this rapier hit.
Well, he can always just do what EE like prefers to do. Like just buy the butterfly and use the flutter effect to get yourself around the map.
Yeah. Oh man, Secret. At one point, 2 racks up, looked like they were in a really, really good position, but AB strike back after that one fight. It looked so good, too. Secret were sandwiching them in. They knew it was 3v5. They saw the relocate where they came out from, but that the second Ravage really would have changed their fortunes.
The items are being purchased right now, so instead of going for the Butterfly, Hal's actually buying up a Moonshine to consume and purchases up BTs. When the Aegis drops, you can see the Butterfly, but the other big item which arrives, it's a double Hex Tidehunter, not just the double Ravage, thanks to the Refresher Orb, a Scythe of Ice is now over on KP. They are still, however, 2 Raxes down. We have to keep this in mind, the Secret, they're still just a bottom lane away from Megas.
I don't think that matters though anymore. In a game like this, Mega Creeps don't impact anything. You've got Hal that can pretty much deal with it as long as he wants, and same with Mu. Because he's got such high armor, and he's got lifesteal, Mega Creeps don't bother him. Tidehunter's in a similar position. They three ideal cores to deal with it. So Secret can't even go down Suicide for that bottom racks to try to win the game. That would mean nothing. The scary thing right now for Secret is they have to win a team fight, a straight up 5v5 team fight to win the game. Then they have to push your throne.
That seems almost impossible facing the control that Newbie has and the damage they have.
That's why this game became so scary, because even though most of the time you'd say the team that was up two sets of racks to none is in a really good spot, it's 62 minutes into the game, the Gyrocopter has a Divine Rapier and Flat Cannon. What do you care about Mega Creeps?
Newbie is hunting. Can I move up to the Dire Secret shop? But Secret are currently having tea at home.
Oh,
Puppy is the lone person going out. This is at least one way to stop it. I think it was the old Miracle strat when they ran ET as well as Nagasara, and you send your illusions and your spirit down the mid, and there was no way you could actually get a creep wave beyond the river. Puppy's just trying to relieve any kind of pressure.
Yeah,
but Newbie seem fine with this.
That cheese is still on Arteezy, by the way.
Is it?
A few fights in a row now where he just hasn't been able to get it off.
Well, that's when we looked at Chorn. Like, Chorn's been all over him like a hot rash.
What? Alright. Wispin, Gyrocopter get a TP back bottom. And I think this is where the assault begins. They feel pretty comfortable at this position. They've hemmed in Secret. They know they can win a team fight with this Hex, the double Hex, double Ravage.
Mm-hmm.
Even if he misses on the first Ravage, which he did, doesn't matter. You'll catch him with the second one.
Yeah.
No refresher on the side of Team Secret. Those are 5 second BKBs. You have to take Newbie in a fight, though, if you want to hold Rax.
Well, Al's, he's approaching the front lines. They avoid the Spirit Stomp. And now Arteezy with the Shiva's Guard. All he does is just hit the creep wave, but Hal, he's fine with this. They move forward, now goes into Dragon Form, Eternal Limb. He actually got missiles, so he's on the back lines. They Lotus Orb over onto the Death Prophet, trying to keep Arteezy alive, but there's the Ravage. They all go bouncing up and down as KP goes for another hit. He hits four of them again. Puppy will go down. The buybacks are coming out. Universe stranded on the front lines. The bottom rack is already in the sidelines as Envy, BKBs, front line, Newbie. They want to disengage. Moo may be the sacrificial lamb, but he's also got Satanic. Turns around. Can't keep the attacks coming, however. Chorn tried to be the space creator, but it wasn't enough. He can't even blink himself away. He might have a 4-star for the moment. He'll lose the gem if they can only catch up to him, and there it is. The splitter as well as Spirit Siphons being committed to kill off Chorn. Bottom racked is gone. You keep your rapier in the hands of Hal.
You have the buyback available on the Dragon Knight 2. It's a 7k gold built up Hal as well. Could go for the second rapier.
But you actually get a second rapier,
too.
Or are you still looking to the butterfly?
If you go for the second rapier, you're in a position where you can just die one time, which is perfectly fine, and he's 300 gold away from being able to buy the second one.
He's walking, and with 7.9k, he is actually building a satanic.
Yeah, I guess
Okay, survivability.
That's perfectly fine. Oh. Okay, I can keep him alive for the initial burst, then he can pop the satanic. And it's not like Secret can fight into that core anyways. Secret now are in the unenviable position where both their major cores have used their buybacks, and they barely just repelled them. They lost their racks at bottom, which is the one lane that they didn't have control over, so now they're going to constantly have to push that one out,
yeah,
which is going to be annoying for them. And even, again, straight up pushing in a bottom might not necessarily win them the game, but looks like Secret...
It's like their only window of opportunity, right? Like, the double Ravage is down.
Yeah, but
you actually don't have a Ravage for 50 seconds. Like, it's the only window.
I think so, too. Because if you wait for the double Ravage, Newbie can look for any one engagement and the game is over. So take it to them. Try to win the game off of this. Universe can not boot to travel
here
over.
They come. Eternal Envy actually gets a 65-minute Hurricane Pike.
Push people away.
Give him the distance. At least it's almost a guaranteed, like, heal from the Satanic.
Yeah.
Because that's not something going to stop him.
Problem right now is... If you lose this one engagement, of course the game ends. If you lose Eternal Envy or Arteezy, the game ends. There are a lot of different ways where Secret just lose the game. And Newbie, even losing Hao at this point, does not mean the game is over. That's the scary part. Team Secret. Losing their rapier no longer ensures Secret
a
win.
Oh, I don't know if that was intentional. Hao just got left behind. He's got BTs available anyway.
They are
anyway.
Running their way over. He has to get out of there
now. He's got BTs on him, so he's fine. He's straight back home,
oh,
but
they're making their way in.
They know
the double Ravage is down.
They're gonna slip in from behind. You've still got one Ravage up. It's 36 seconds until double Ravage is there for KP. He'll move forward to the front lines.
I cannot
they break
believe
the smoke. Now
this.
They realize it's the back three-man wall. That catch out three
but is it enough? Khan got four stuffed away. The Ghost Head will protect him, and how? The damage, they're focusing
the
down.
The BKBs are fading.
The splitter is happening. Khan gets stunned for the moment. KP, you already had to use the Ravage.
Secret
the Vivex coming back. Secret are actually assaulting inside Doobie's home, and Moo's in trouble. Lotus off, they stun themselves up.
They're gonna have to do it twice, though. The Vivex come.
So low. How? Backing out. He doesn't have the immortality. Satanic's on cooldown for 13 more seconds, but they haven't taken the next lane of Rax. You take a fight, you force the Vivex, but you haven't achieved any other objective yet.
Unbelievable that Secret even come close to winning that fight inside the Newbie base.
They're coming forward. How is Hex up? Kaka, he's no longer tethered. Will they have enough time? Moo comes in from behind. Eternal Limb is going to get stunned up. Kaka, 3 seconds until they can pull back out again. The back from Universe comes back out. You've got Eternal Limb now isolated. How will bring him down? 105 seconds without the Sama. Hatsizi has to keep running too. He can't BT. He's got no BT, but he's actually made to juke it around the tree line. They don't realize where he's gone. He moves back over to the midway for this. There's no radiant creep wave to give him vision. They're on the run. They have to know he's gone somewhere, but you're basically chasing up after Arteezy
when you want to be assaulting.
Can they catch him?
Oh, they're going to see the Shivas too.
Oh boy.
And with the creep wave coming in, if Arteezy dies here, he doesn't have buyback.
He almost has to actually go for the radiant base, pick up, go and BT out. Like BKB and TP out, that's the only hope he's got. The missile's chasing him down. He makes the run. There's the TP. Arteezy!
The damage is so good.
The damage is too much. He can't survive. 2 minutes now without Arteezy. Newbie are still in damage control. They still have to repair the top and mid lane.
Part of the problem, though, is Newbie know for a fact there's no buyback up on that DP. They're reasonably certain there's going to be no buyback on that Huskar. Just bought that Hurricane Pike. Doesn't even have the gold for it. This is now going to be their opportunity.
It's stall time, though. You see what Puppy's doing? The first thing he did was run towards the middle lane. He stomps the wave. He slows down the push here of Newbie as much as he possibly can.
I think Secret are in a position where they can be okay with giving away one set of racks. Giving away Mega Creeps might be a little bit too much for this lineup to handle, but
so you
it's
just,
all going to come down to these
trying,
three.
You just keep trying to stall them.
Yeah.
That's all.
You slow down the assault. You force whatever you can. You got to buy at least a little bit of more time for this Huskar to come back up. I was gonna boot to travel in now.
Oh, the moment, Newbie. They attack. They go, wow, that tower. It doesn't stand a chance. They still have fortification here, Secret. 5 seconds until Envy is up, but you're still missing your Death Prophet. They move for the Megas. Universe, double wall would be the hope, the prayer that it could actually do something, but you got 43 seconds until Envy. The timer is too much. He backs, and then the initiation. KP's gonna catch it. Universe doesn't have buyback. He's down. He can't even get the refresh drop. Envy's gone. I think the hope from Team Secret will go with him. Envy will be shallow graved up to try and survive. Puppy almost trying to use himself as a distraction. Envy will jump forward, but the damage, the physical is still too much. How is a beast? And how will take the kill over on the poor little Envy Huskar? The top ranks will join him too. You can stomp up 14 seconds until Arteezy. This is the last thing the Secret will have, which could potentially repel Newbie, who are now megged against Team Secret. They're actually backing out. They're gonna give Secret breathing room. Roshan is available, but they're not going to go for the GG push.
I sort of think they should. There's still 73 seconds to go for Envy. If he had buyback, he would have used it to try, at least try to save against Mega Creeps, but Darkseer down too.
They want Roshan first.
Yeah, they're going to secure. They know. They've still got the Refresher Ravage about to come up too. Any sort of single team fight one is going to mean the game for them. With the Aegis and Cheese, it's going to make it that much harder for Team Secret to the line here once again. Smoke's gonna come out, but it's just gonna be to get to the mid lane even faster. Newbie are not the type of team to allow Mega Creeps to do their work for them.
How many games do you have where an Io will take the Aegis over a DK who takes the cheese instead?
Oh, he needs it to be able to save this Gyrocopter. The Aegis is gonna be really useful on him. Now you've got the Refresher already popped on the KP. He wants to make sure he has it for this fight. Got an Octarina available as well.
24 seconds. 22 seconds. Count it down until the Secret are back at full force. You still have now Darkseer back with his full combo with the Refresher Orb. So we can make a play for that. 13 seconds to go. The tier 4 tower's dropping. Arteezy will now trigger the ultimate. They try and slow down Newbie. Universe still can't find that opening just yet. And they jump forward. There's your back. You want to call out how the BKBs will go. KP, not a great ultimate. May still be another. They can kill off Arteezy. They've managed to bring him down. Where is the extra damage? He's back to the front lines, but you've already got your fortress open, ready for attack. The stomp from Puppy helps them set up. Universe, where is the dream? It's just not there. You've already used the Refresher. Ashrol. There's nothing more to fight with. Karka tethers over. He keeps Howl alive and Envy now isolated. This should be it. With the Hex up, Universe is also dropping quickly. The Shallow Grave just prolongs the inevitable, which is Eternal Envy dying. Universe will go down to, and there it is. GG. It looked like the newbie streak was going to be ended by Team Secret here in game number two, but after 71 minutes and 47 seconds, newbie will take the series 2-0 against Team Secret.
Unbelievable display of skill from both teams, but newbie come out on top. Just superior team fight throughout. They held their high ground for